Years ago, he told me there was a beautiful city that rose up out of the water. It housed many people inside its walls, and the people had everything they wished for.
You must continue. Bring me a red page. Blue pages.
That is a red page. And here's the blue page, and black ships appeared on the horizon. The lookout post attempts at peace were turned away, and the sentries there were easily overwhelmed. So we got cowbell, we got exhaust, we got clink, and we got spin. Cirrus, your greed sickens me. Your desire for wealth and splendor is never satisfied. That honestly just looks like something decapitated. Maybe the enemy hasn't been defeated. Is it time? It's military time, isn't it? I know those constellations refer to these. What I think I remember where I think it's in the book. I think I might need to read the book actually. Hold on. So then we're going to Stone Ship, which is this one. Okay, let's get ready for some good old reading. Okay, Emmett was the first to live on the rocks. What's interesting is I think we heard of Emmett in the mechanical age because he said he wondered how Emmett was doing. So maybe he was referring to the Stone Ship age whenever he meant that. Emmett was the first to live on the rocks. He named them the rocks because that is what they were, a group of sharp rocks clustered together in the middle of a large sea. This was where Emmett lived. He enjoyed his life. Emmett would occasionally swim to nearby rocks as it was never too far of a distance. In case of Mist Island, there were wood surfaces embedded in the green that act as buttons to trigger a feature. That's kind of fun. One day, another person appeared on the rocks for no apparent reason to Emmett. Emmett named this new person Branch. Emmett and Branch quickly became friends, swimming and hunting for fish together often. Emmett showed Branch the simple cave in which he lived on the largest rock. Soon, Branch discovered a place where he decided to live, also on the same large rock. The sun always shone brightly in their world, and the water was always dazzlingly clear, allowing them to see almost to the deep ocean floor which surrounded them. Though the sun always shone, it was never too hot for the boys. A light breeze always came from the north and cooled the area down. One day, while Branch was swimming and having fun in the water, he noticed another boy swimming. Branch brought the new boy to Emmett to find out what to call the new boy. Emmett said the boy should be called Will. Will was soon a part of the group, and all three of the boys swam and enjoyed their perfect world. That is the story I was told when I arrived today on the island. Emmett, Branch, and Will were surprised to see me at first, but even before the night ended, we were all becoming good friends. Today, the second day on this newly created age, a strange thing happened. It was not strange to me, but the three boys did not understand what was happening. While I was relaxing under a large tree on... Oh, crap, my phone. Sorry. While I was relaxing under a large tree on one of the smaller rock islands, it began to rain. It was a nice rain that lasted for about an hour in the morning. I explained to the boys that the rain was not harmful, yet they obviously still feared it. Before going to sleep tonight, I told the boys I would leave the following day. I told them while I was gone, I would make a surprising change in their world. They didn't understand, not that I expected them to. Also, every course has an altered, harder version that you unlock by either finding all 18 lost balls on the course or hitting under par. Huh. Interesting. I'm a sucker for mini golf, and now that you mentioned there's a VR game for mini golf, that would have sold me anyway, but now there's a Myst DLC. Absolutely. I'm going to be checking out that game at some point. I still do not fully understand what happened today. Nice little drawing of shit. I was experimenting with the art, testing the limits of the rules as dictated to me by father. I attempted to create a boat by writing it into the world. I thought everything was planned correctly, yet somehow the boat had become gripped by the rock and broken in half. Although this test did not turn out as I had hoped, I now have answers to a few of the questions my father never answered. As for the boat, I can see the boys enjoy it anyway, and with that I am pleased. They have played on it all day. Even though the boat cannot move, I have enjoyed studying from it. It is a much sturdier platform than jagged rocks. In the course of my observations, I have learned some very interesting things regarding the solar system of this age. Submersible lamp. Okay. The nights are absolutely beautiful here. I have made note of and named a number of constellations that pass above me. Referencing the constellations that we are now about to probably put in. Those wouldn't be the constellations of the Stoneship Age, because those are the constellations of the Myst Age. Huh. And when you unlock the harder version of the course, there is a fox hunt that you can do to unlock a themed putter for that course. Huh. What? Fox hunt? What is a fox hunt? Also, during the night, I catch glimmers of light from the horizon, which I have not been able to discover if it is created by some natural phenomena or by additional people on far-off islands or rocks. I should very much like to discover which. I rather suspect it's additional people, which would explain the appearance of Branch and Will. The rain today was slightly heavier than usual. Just when the boys were getting used to the light rains, a small storm arrived. They were frightened of the heavier rain, not to mention the thunder and lightning. If rain has never fallen here until recently, as the boys tell me, I would like to discover why it is falling now. Regardless, I have decided to return home for a short while. I have also been thinking of some plans for a lighthouse that I hope to construct soon. I think that perhaps by shining a bright light towards the horizon, it might prove my suspicions regarding additional inhabitants. They would be curious about the light and travel to discover its source, if they have the means. I returned with many tools that I will need for construction of the lighthouse. I have decided that once the lighthouse is complete, I will leave for some time and let the world's own imagination have control. Fox hunt is like a scavenger hunt composed of a series of clues that each leads you to the next. Okay. We have worked 3 weeks on the lighthouse now and are making great progress. The rock that we are building on seems to not be as secure as I would like. I have had to alter my plan slightly, but those alterations pose no real problem. There's a light at the top of the lighthouse, noted. The boys are quite strong and have been helping me immensely. I estimate construction will be done within 2 days. The lighthouse is finished, and we are all proud of our creation. The boys are amazed at the structure wrought from rock with their own hands. That evening, we powered up the generator, much to the boys' dread at first, and shined a great light to the horizon for many hours. I stayed the night in the top of the lighthouse, and in the morning awoke to observe the sunrise without my being coated in chilly blank. Wait, hold on, what? I awoke to observe the sunrise without my being coated with the chilly blanket of ocean dew I had become accustomed to. That's an interesting structure. That kind of threw me for a loop. It was Will who first saw the girl. She was swimming not far from the boat where Will was getting ready to hunt for fish. Then Will noticed a man not far away from the girl. Emmett was very pleased to meet the additional neighbors. I feel pleased to leave this age, and I have set in motion events that have nothing to do with writing or the art, that will have a more profound impact on the world than I could have ever written, I think. And there's a map of the age. Cool. So this looks like the ship that he tried to retroactively write into the age. And then we have a couple pathways. This one looks like it leads to the lighthouse, and this kind of like looks up, goes up the mountain. Oh. I think of it this age as a gift to myself that I will wrap up and open someday in the future, only to discover that it has changed so much that indeed it is a surprise. Besides, I have yet another new age that awaits me. It seems I'm going to need some way to travel underwater in this new age, and so much planning is in order. Imagine what you might see if you were in the age when the change is being... Dude, I know, right? I was thinking that... I was reading this, and I'm like, what are they seeing? Are they seeing, scribbles of the ship being, like, drawn? Obviously Atreus would be writing the on the page, so he wouldn't actually be drawing a ship. He would be writing words that would then turn into the ship. So are they like seeing like just various different parts of the ship come into existence at one at a time, or is it fading into existence all like that's interesting to think about, like what they would actually see, or does it not pop into existence until he's completely done writing it? It has been 10 years since I left this age, which I have since called the Stone Ship Age. Upon returning, I cannot believe the changes that have taken place. The original three boys have grown into adults, and there are many new faces that I do not recognize. Branch told me that it does not rain for 7 years, and the cool breezes are back again. They are all very content and have been serving me with new food, showing me new materials they have discovered. It even seems they have found gold somewhere. I see it in many forms around the island. Might be more like a dream to... That's true. Interesting. Huh. That really makes you think about how the art of writing actually happens. Which is going to be even more interesting when we get to Myst 3, because I know Myst 3 is a lot about... a lot of lore about actually writing ages. I mean, so does Riven, though, to be fair. My lighthouse has been kept in perfect condition, and it looks as if they have tried their very best to keep it so. Yet I have noted the entire rock it was built on has sunk approximately 40 or 50 centimeters. After a wonderful visit with my old friends, I wonder aloud with them what things will be like here in another 10 years. Like, is it something that isn't quite real until it's done? Could be interesting. It could be like that. Yeah, they could have like a sense of deja vu of like, huh, why do I feel like I've seen this before? But then it's like the first time they're seeing it. Interesting. But more importantly, here we have the key to... Oh god, that freaking skeeter ears, I swear to god. It like I don't know if you know what those are or not, but they're like giant insects that look almost like mosquitoes, but they're too big to be mosquitoes. And at this time of year, they're everywhere. And no matter how hard you try it, they're going to get into your house. And I saw one just like fly like right past my eye, and it scared the crap out of me. But yeah, so here is the key. But I was right. This these four is gonna be the eye. So this one is the leaf, so we need the leaf and the eye. And it looks like the beetle. I think this is the one that we had that was the beetle. Oh, didn't mean to take it. Well, sure, we'll take a picture of that. Okay. So we got the eye that needs to stay on. We have the snake go off, the beetle stays on, anchor goes off. Arrow goes off. Leaf stays on. You go off, and you go off. And there's the ship. Which means you are now raised. I love the water detailing. You can definitely tell it's been underwater. And here is the book to the Stone Ship Age. And probably like the mechanical, we're not going to have a way to go back until we actually solve the age. Curious to see, because yeah, I see what you see about the mirroring, because we were on a ship, and when we came here, we're now on a ship again. Really hoping Cyan partners with Walkabout Mini Golf again. I would love to see a Riven course, maybe for the Riven remake. That could be fantastic. Looks like everything's flooded. And this is the ship that's now cut in half with the, stone. Oh god, the thunder in the distance. That's actually amazing. Dude, that's sunset. Look at that. That's pretty. That's pretty. That's a screenshot pretty. Got some kind of gear shift over here? That's a weird noise. All these passageways are flooded. There's that lighthouse. Can we go to the lighthouse? We can go to the lighthouse right here. Looks like a light, but they don't have, there's no power right now. What? Oh, the ladder's embedded into the wall. Oh, that's kind of weird. I can't climb it. Yeah, because it's like inside the wall. If you look at it straight on, it does not look like it's inside the ball, but then you come up, like, that's kind of weird. Okay, so we need to figure out a way to, I guess, have this ladder poke out? Oh, hi, key. What the heck? What? I do not remember this at all. Like, what the heck is this supposed to, like, what am I supposed to do with this key? Obviously, this is different than the original mist, because I do not remember a key in the original mist. Mighty Coconut, the company that makes Walkabout, did tweet a possible interest, and Eric Anderson, the head of Cyan, replied to stay in touch. Ooh. Uh-oh. Got another collab going on. Okay, so we got a key. Got some kind of metal contraption. And again, the bottom of the lighthouse is flooded. Okay. We can go up top too. In the original game, the key was on a short chain on the wood deck. This chain was made to be VR friendly. Oh. Okay. I still do not remember there being a key So that's actually, I actually might be a little stumped in this age. We'll see what actually happens. Let's continue exploring. Ah, yeah, the telescope. I do remember the telescope. What? Oh, it moves based on where my cursor is. Okay, that's a little weird. Is there anything in particular that I'm supposed to be looking for? There's a, like, the ship's mast. This telescope music's also very nostalgic. There is the lighthouse. And then the other ship mast. Other than that, I don't really see anything else besides rock formations. There's two ship masts, which leads me to believe that I should probably have the lighthouse as the thing that I'm lining up. The issue is, so that's like 70. In fact, a lot of interactives are now at least as high as waist level for that reason. Oh, okay, that's cool. I mean, I didn't really notice any, like, major differences until that, like, well, I noticed major differences, but, like, not, like, as in, like, what the hell is this doing here? I don't remember this at all type thing until that key. So, okay, I'm gonna go ahead and take a picture of this. That looks like it's gonna be, because, like, that would be, 75 would be that short, the, crap, I can't. Stop moving. Here, it'll be easier if I do this, probably. Nope, don't camera. There we go. So go here. So this short line will be 65. Which means a lighthouse would be, it looks like it's directly between 65 and 70, which would make it either 67 or 68, probably. Could be a combo for something, so 68 or some, or 67 or 68. I mean, I don't even know if that's like, I legitimately do not remember how to start this age, in all honesty. So I thought that was a page for a second. I was like, there's no way the page is out here. How do you, I feel like I need to do something with you if I, oh, interesting. So you were right there to begin with. If I do that, silence kind of like a pump, so I think if I remember right, this is a pump that pumps the water. Staying green. Okay, yeah, that pumped the water out of the tunnels. Okay, so these are like three different pumps, but I can only have one of them active at a time. So that did that tunnel. This one is going to do this tunnel? No. This one's going to do, oh, this one did the ship. Oh, dude, look at the water remaining. I love that. I thought the water's kind of still showing there. Oh, it's cool. It kind of has like a stone passageway. Bro. This is kind of cool. Okay. What the heck? That's a... I almost thought that was a hose for a second, but then I realized it continues past the window. I thought, I was like, why is this table going to be sucking in water? And then I was like, oh no, it continues. So that's probably like a power cable or something. So probably need to get power to you. It seems like the key for this age is figuring out how to get power while managing water pumps is like what it seems like. So, and then on top of that, we need to keep an eye out for the two pages. So let's, let's do you. I think you're the one that pumps the water out of the, yeah, you're pumping the water out of this tunnel. Okay. It's really spooky. Spooky dark tunnel. Bunch of different fabrics. Nothing. Oh, oh no, come back out. Looks like some gold coins. A tiara and some gems. I feel like the movement speed is slightly too fast. Is there a movement speed setting? Not look sensitivity, movement speed. I don't think there's a movement speed setting. Bunch of candles, just a bunch of silverware and candles, or not silverware, dishware. Yeah, that's what I meant. Spin the globe. Spin the pink globe. Okay. What's over here? This is reminding me of the parrot, or not, it wasn't a parrot, it was, oh, hi, red page. I was so focused on that thing, I didn't even see the red pages right there. That's great. This is reminding me of the bird from, like, Cirrus's room that, like, had just purely there just to be a random interactive. You have curtains made with that black ship's fabric? Wait, hold on. This black ship's, wait a sec, hold on. Are you talking, I can't crouch, but are you talking about like right there with like the cross and crescent moon? Because if so, that reminds me of the, the ship's banner from the mechanical age, which means if this is the red page was found in Cirrus's room, which means this is probably Cirrus's room, which means if Cirrus has that fabric, is Cirrus the one responsible for, or is Cirrus the enemy of the mechanical age? Huh. Okay, well, we got the red page out of here, which I'm assuming is the point of this room besides the environmental storytelling. Oh, there's drawers here. Oh, hi, dagger and poison. We're gonna just put you back away. Hi, more poisons and injections and pills. Holy crap, okay. That got dark really fast. You can buy it on a site called Spoonflower. The pattern was made by a mist fan that based on the bolt of fabric seen there. Is that ambience? I feel like there's a door here. I remember there being a secret door in this tunnel. But I can't interact with anything. Spoon flower. Interesting. That's pretty. Dude, just coming out of that was amazing. That's great. Okay, so we need to go. Are you already? Oh, you're already drained. Incidentally, that same mist fan is now working at Cyan. Okay. Great. I love when people that are fans of projects get involved in the projects themselves. Okay. So here is, I'm assuming, going to be Akinar's room? Definitely Akinar's aesthetic. Maps. Marker Swit. The vault is locate the island of achieved very ease. Instructions are follows. Each of the marker turn everyone on position. Then, and as final step, turn there to the yeah, we're just gonna no, I did, I tried to close the door. There we go. A bunch of maps and then just that page in there. A bunch of measuring tools? Yeah, so he was drawing a bunch of maps on here. What are the maps for? Can I actually tell what they're for? I don't recognize any of these lands. That seems like probably not the ages we've been to. Well, I don't know. I mean, they could be. We've only gone to two ages, and they've been very small segments of those two ages. I remember this. You turn into a skull, don't you? You freaked me out as a kid. It's a little cheesy now with it just wiggling back and forth. I remember this just being extremely demonic, especially with the music that was playing in the background. Because the music that's playing is the exact same. It's the exact same soundtrack. And there's the blue page. Okay, so we got both the pages. Now we need to figure out how to actually just get out of the age. Are there drawers down here? I can't. Probably not. It's too dark. Okay. So it's really... What's interesting is I'm getting vibes that... And this is me actually not being biased because of colors, because... But I really feel like, so far, Akinar is the one that is... most trustworthy, because even though of his very freaking get out of here, there you go. Okay, Skeety Eater came back. With his very interesting aesthetic choices, he's The fabric being found inside of Cirrus's room is very very criminalizing, I think the term is incriminating. There we go. Very criminalizing. What is the issue? I know you're a door. Why do you not open? I remember this very vividly now. There is a secret door right here. How do I open you? How do I open you is the question. Okay. So, oh wait, we still have one more pump, which I'm going to... assume drains the lighthouse now, because we have the ship and we got the other two. There's another place filled with water. It does drain. What are you? Water? Is this the only interactable on you? The valve? It's also a very interesting valve. Okay. What the heck? I don't get this at all. Wait, hold on. You're a chest with a lock on you. You're a rope that is attached to you. So if you float, you'll be right there and I'll be able to use that key to unlock the chest. So I need to refill the water? Why weren't you floating? Oh, because you had water in you. So you were weighed down. Oh. Can I just press this again and it'll repump the water back in there? Or no, it won't. I have to do this. Put you up there. Then do that. There we go. That type of valve is a kind of both letting water out of the bottom and something letting air in the top of it. Okay. As I thought. There we go. And it gives me another key. Okay. A key to a key. This is also on a string. Are you? What am I supposed to do with you now? What? What do you go into? How far away can I? You're not very far. Okay. You know, I should check. Does that ladder, when the water is drained, does that ladder come out? That's back. Boy, okay, wait. So maybe now something I can do something at the bottom with it now that it's open with a key. Might want to look at the wall with the ladder more. Oh. Thank you. Thank you for saving me probably, I don't even know how long, just wandering around trying to figure out random things. Okay, and now we're at the top of the lighthouse. Whoa! Okay. Okay, you're at full power now. Did we just give power to the island? Yes, there's now lights going. Okay. Ha! Huh. Light. Maybe now that there's power, those two secret doors will be active. Is the middle one the one that I needed to do for the... Yes. Oh, the door's just open. Okay. I heard an interesting reason for why the screen goes black when you turn the lights on. Oh, why is that? I thought it was just like an effect or whatever, but if there's actually a reason for it, I would like to hear it. Dude, going on that passageway with the dom dom. You're that light. Several of you. Okay. I'm assuming this goes to the other hallway. It does. Okay. You're pointing at you. Do I press you? Uh-oh. Are we in trouble? Oh, it's interesting. They have a handle from behind them. Do you close if I go? No. That's going down. I need to go back up. Okay, so I gotta figure out which one of those buttons to press. And I pressed the wrong one. I have to go. Interesting. I'm gonna have to go. Reset the power. Okay. This version of the game originally came out for the Quest, and it had trouble processing such a way that changing lighting map needs a full... Oh! Oh, that's actually really interesting. Okay. That's actually really cool. So, because... turning the lights on actually makes the power come on, and things are going to be visible that aren't visible, and the lighting maps are going to be different. They have to completely... So, is it like two different renderings of the same location? Because these aren't dynamic lights, obviously, then. Because if they were dynamic lights, you wouldn't need lighting maps. These are actually static, baked-in lighting. Is that right? And because the lighting changes, they needed to have two different renderings of the map of the age. I say map because that's what it's called in gaming terminology. Yes, but lights require different lighting. Yeah. Okay. Now I remember you are correlated with the telescope, so we need to 67 or 68. But the issue is, which one of you is 67 and 68? So that's north, south, west, east. Flowerheart finally missed. Welcome to the Dragon Den, Flowerheart. How you doing? Good to see new faces in here. Yes, finally missed. I just got through playing Abduction last week a little bit, and I'm not blind playing through this, but it's been a long time, so there's puzzles like the one I'm staring at right now that I'm a little rusty on. I love Myst 2. I love Myst 2. It's a great, great franchise, and I am excited to be playing it. I can honestly completely forget how to solve this. I have to figure out. I think zero would be. What the heck? Oh, even if I just run out, the power drains? Or was it timed? I think it was timed? Problem with being a gamer is that you really want to talk about surreal exploration genre, but no one knows anything about surreal exploration genre. Oh, I love surreal exploration genre. My whole thing is I love exploring games, going on these journeys and adventures, and then analyzing them, looking into what the different meanings could be, the story, learning new things. Like in Abduction, I learned all about base 4 and that kind of stuff. So it's not like I love just learning new things and having these experiences and stuff. I've been wondering for so long why the screen goes black, and I learned only yesterday. Really? Oh, that's awesome. Have I played Yumi? I have never heard of that. What kind of a game is it without giving spoilers? LSD. I've heard of LSD Dream Emulator. Yes, I never played it personally, but I have watched so many videos on LSD Dream Emulator. The other four that you've listed, I have not heard of, though. Great, my list of games is about to expand. Okay, so we need, I'm assuming zero is north, which means we need to go 20, 30, 60, about 67 to 68 degrees. Off of north. Yumi Nikki is the surreal explore. Oh, I think I go turn the power back on. Is the surreal exploration game. Game that a lot of people got inspired from. Oh, okay. I'll have to definitely check that out then for sure. Time for black screen. Time to change the lighting map. Okay. You know, I guarantee you, this is timed, because why would we need to do it three times to charge this meter? This thing absolutely is timed. Okay. So I need to figure this out, and I'm timed. Great. I love timing things. I'm horrible when it comes to timing puzzles. I don't think this is actually a timing puzzle, per se. I just have a time limit to put the solution in. Also, about Myst, I actually prefer the old 2D version. That was the one I played originally. I originally played the point and click 2D one. When I was figuring out that I was going to play through all of the Myst games, I decided I was going to play the new one just to see if there's any changes. And there have been actually changes. Some of them I like, some of them I don't. So, like more because every single image of the point and click one, there was so much visually, like there was so much you could look at and decipher in each individual frame. And like, yes, there's still a lot here, but it's not just on your screen, if that makes it's weird talking about it, but I think only people who played point and clicks actually kind of understand that. Okay, so that's zero, so I need to go. The issue is, how many over are you? I'm assuming there's 360 degrees, right? Like normal directions. So zero, and then I would need to go. Oh, the time ran out. But there's no alarm, so I can still kind of keep staring at this a little bit. Okay. I'm assuming these don't work whenever the power's out. Yeah, okay. As a person who played all Rusty late games can relate. I haven't even played the Rusty late games. Oh my gosh, you're adding so many games to my mental list that I'm gonna have to look into. Oh my god. Okay. So we got... ...360 degrees. Which would mean this would be 90 degrees. So it's in this somewhere. And the issue is we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different buttons between 90 and 0. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 buttons between 90 and 0. So what degree would each of these represent? What is halfway between... God, I can't think of this off the top of my head. What is halfway between 90... ...135 is between 90 and 180, so that would mean it would be... 45. I don't know why I bugged on that for a second. 45 would be right here. So that would mean... ...one of you two is the one I need to press. What's interesting is, like, this one is on the black arrow. This one's in between... these two arrows. Wait. No, I'm sorry. One of these three is the one I need to press. Okay, there's one in between each arrow, and there's one on each arrow. Oh god, what's halfway between 45 and 90 is, 67. Yeah, 67. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is the one we need to press right here. Oh my gosh, that is a huge list of stuff. Woo! That is a lot of things to look into. And then at the end, Digimon. Oh, that's great. I love that. Okay, let's go turn on the power and let's go. Test out my theory. Listen, what do you mean listen? I didn't say anything was wrong with Digimon. Digital world is weird as hell. Yeah, that I've watched a bunch of Digimon, but I always watched it for the different Digimon. I never actually pay attention to any of the lore or anything. I watched it when I was super, super young, so I never really paid attention to any of the actual lore or story going on. I always just pay attention to the battles. Okay, so we got this one? It's different. Yeah! Okay. That list is going to take, is going to need some time to digest, because there's a lot of stuff on there that I have never even heard of. But 100%, I will definitely look into that, and more than likely will at some point, maybe not everything on that list, because that, but a lot of that stuff I probably will get to. Especially since you said, especially the Yumi Nikki, I will probably definitely look at, look into that and start playing that. Is that just a single game, or is that actually a game series? What did that do? Hold on, I just ran out of there like I knew what I was doing next. What did that actually do? So, is the power eternally on now? Did I like... Well, the lights are on outside. Well, that's kind of a cool... you can play Yumi Nikki even in browser. Oh, wow. Interesting. Oh, there's like a light. That's probably the clue that I'm supposed to have to know that that lighthouse is supposed to be the... I just guessed based on the fact that it was like the only unique thing there is. What do I do now? Maybe with the power on, there's something different down in this ship. Hold on. Yeah, I really do not remember this age very well, apparently. Like, the mechanical age, I remembered pretty well. This age, I did not remember very well. Okay, there's lights on down here now. And there's music. There wasn't music before, unless I'm going crazy. There's power. This button works now, right? Oh! Wait. What was the point of solving the compass rose? If the power... Maybe this wouldn't have worked unless I solved the compass rose. I didn't even think about this, but maybe I should have checked that before. Oh, well. Well, back to Mist we go. That's the second age down, and we will probably do Channel Wood next. And then I will... The compass rose turned on the... Okay, yeah, okay. That's what I was, like, thinking, but I was at the same time, I was like, wait, if only this needed power, maybe the compass rose directed the power to that room or something. Okay, let's talk to Akinar first this time.
Good.
Oh god, that was so creepy. You're back!
The more blue pages you find, bring more. I must have some more. That's all I ask of you. It's been so long since my brother wrongfully imprisoned me within this book.
Oh god, I forgot about the distortion. The whole face is just turning in on itself.
Pretty speech. Greed, which is endless. It should be perfectly obvious to you. He's done evil and he has destroyed all before. Do not bring the red pages to him. Please. Not let him trick you. He tricked our father. Hideously murdered our father! He'll trick you! He'll murder you. Don't touch the red pages.
Man, I'm sad Atris is dead.
Bring the blue pages.
Barely got to know him.
To me. Listen, you must obey me. Blue pages are my only hope. You must help me. You must help me. You must help me.
Damn, he's actually going crazier and crazier the more we talk to him. Must get sleep one more time before work. I will have fun, Parker. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope to see you again. And your help is always greatly appreciated. Thank you for confirming the 67 0.5 for that compass rose. Okay, and now let's talk to Cirrus.
Have returned.
Two more. Okay.
I am released. I promise. Don't touch the blue pages.
Oh, I'm touching them.
That is where my mind runs. For my wicked brother,
Akinar. I really think you're the most guilty one so far.
He is a man of distorted mind and senses.
You're so dramatic. Oh my god! He disgusts me!
Do not release Akinar. Thirst for destruction is not. Never ending. Bring the red paint. May you please release me from this prison. Promise you will be greatly rewarded.
I'm about to be encased in a tree! Oh, here's the other half of that torn note. He is preparing?
I hope I pushed the right button.
Suspicions are raising on both of them.
Remember, take only